بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، in today's episode we shall talk about the sleeping of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. A Sahih hadith is mentioned in Tirmidhi, and Bara bin Azib رضي الله عنه reports that when Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم went to the bed to sleep, he put his right hand under his right cheek and recited this dua: Rabbi qini azabak yawma tab'athu ibadak. O Allah, save me from your punishment on the day of Qiyamah. Also, another Sahih hadith mentioned in Muslim is related by Abu Qatada radiallahu anhu. He relates, if Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made an early journey break in the last portion of the night on his travels, he slept on his right side. If he was staying there till before the morning, he lifted his right arm, put his head on it and slept. A hadith which is narrated by Hudhayfa radiallahu anhu is sahih and is in Bukhari, wherein he says, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lay down on a bed, he recited, Allahumma bismika amutu wa ahya. O Allah, in your name do I live and die. And when he woke up, he recited, Alhamdulillahilladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana wa ilayhin nushur. Praise be to Allah who restored life unto us, having caused us to die, and unto him shall be the resurrection. Also, another Sahih hadith, which is once again in Bukhari, is narrated by Aisha radiallahu anha. She says, every night before Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam slept on his bed, he put together his hands as in the dua and blew on it and recited the surah, Suratul Ikhlas, Surah Falaq and Suratul Nas, and wiped those parts of the body that he could wherever the hand could reach. He began with the head, then the face, and then the front part of his body, and this was done thrice. And finally, another Sahih hadith is in Muslim and is narrated by Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu, and he says, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to the bed, he recited this dua: Alhamdulillahilladhi at'amana wa saqana wa kafana wa awana fa kam mimman la kafi'a lahu wa la mu'wi. Praise be to Allah who gave us food and drink, provided us sufficiently, and gave us a place for shelter. How many there are who have neither a provider nor a shelter? We should know that there are two types of deaths. One is when we permanently leave this world and we do not know when that is. And one is when we sleep, because we do not know if we would wake up the following morning. We can sleep tonight and not wake up tomorrow. Question is, are we sleeping pleasing Allah or displeasing Him? From the time we wake up till the time we sleep, we are engaged in multiple activities which are good and bad. Let us be judges to our own selves and ask, are my sins more than my good deeds, or good deeds more than my sins? Have I pleased and obeyed Allah today, or have I displeased and disobeyed Him? When we have asked these questions, let us ask ourselves one last question: am I prepared and ready to meet Allah if I die tonight? The least, the very least we can do each night before we sleep is seeking forgiveness and reciting the du'as before sleep taught to us by our Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Starting today, each night before we sleep, let us seek forgiveness and recite the du'as of sleep consciously, so that inshallah our sleeps can become a type of worship, and if death befalls on us in our sleep, we would die in the state of worshipping Allah inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of us. Let us connect once again through another episode inshallah. Until then, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.